Oh, how I miss this lake. The sounds from a bird, wooden creaks from the dock, a splash into the abyss, the bubbles tickling my face, the cold air shivering my skin. And yet the water beckons me back. It surrounds me, it warms me, and it lifts me up. I feel strong and immortal in the water. Something shifts inside me. The sounds of the world change underwater. What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another GAL tutorial. Now, in this tutorial, I'm going to be breaking down sound design inside of Premiere Pro. I'm going to show you the workspace that I use, some effects that I used from AudioHero, which I reached out to, and they sponsored this video. They provided the sound effects and the music and the sound design, and they're giving you guys 25% off the Prodigy plan, where you can get up to 50 sound effects and music downloads per month. So you can use my code in the description box to claim that. But the reason why I'm so excited about this tutorial is I love sound. It can really change the way people feel when they're watching your video. If there's poor sound, people are like,
well, what's going on?
If there's captivating sound, they're even more grabbed by your video. So with this opening film, I was actually inspired by a lot of the sound effects, and it helped shape the story. It helped encapsulate the viewer, bring them in underwater. So I'm gonna dive into Premiere Pro, show you how I laid out all the different effects, how I labeled the different tracks, how I mixed it together. It's gonna be a pretty fun tutorial. So thank you, AudioHero, for giving you guys 25% off and sponsoring this video. And let's go ahead and jump on into Premiere. So all of the sound effects and music besides my voiceover are from AudioHero. I organized all of the sound effects into different tracks. For example, audio track 1 only has the sonar beeps. Audio track 2 has all the splash sounds, and so on. You see that I gave each track a custom name. To give your tracks a custom name, go to your audio track mixer, and at the bottom, with the field here, you can type in any track name that you want. But I want to show you how awesome it sounds just with the sound effects only. So let's click on the M button next to both the music and voiceover tracks to mute them. So now let's play it back to hear what it sounds like with the sound effects only. And afterwards, I'll jump into some effects that I added to create more of an underwater feel. So let's dive into some of the effects that I added to the sounds to make it all sound a bit more realistic. So for the bubble sound effects here, if we play the original clip I got from AudioHero, it actually sounds more like a person blowing bubbles into water through a straw. So let's play the original. To make it sound like the bubbles are more underwater, I went to effects and I searched for an effect called low pass. I double-clicked to apply it to the bubble clip in the timeline. Then from the effect controls, I dropped the cutoff down to around 918 hertz, which added some distortion, making it sound more like it's underwater. Now the lower the number here on the cutoff, the more underwater-like distortion you will get. And now let's mute all the tracks and play it back with the effect applied. Another underwater trick you can do is change the speed of an audio clip. So for example, this dive and swim sound effect here, if I double click to play the original from the source panel, you can hear that it doesn't really sound like it's underwater. So when I use this clip for the shot of this guy swimming underwater, where the camera was underwater, I needed to slow down the audio. So I right-clicked on the clip and I went to speed and duration and dropped it down to 75% speed. I also added a low-pass filter at 1300 hertz. Now let's mute all the other tracks, and you can hear that it now sounds like it's much more realistic to underwater. Another trick you can do is keyframe the effects. For example, in this opening shot, we start underwater and go above water. So for the water-like atmosphere effect, I keyframed the low-pass filter to go from 925 all the way to the highest cutoff. So if I mute all the other tracks except for the water-like atmosphere and then turn off the low-pass filter, you can hear what it sounds like before the low-pass filter. Now let's turn it back on and play it back. By keyframing the low-pass cutoff, you can make sound sound like it's going from underwater to above water, and I applied the same technique anytime the camera went above and below throughout the video edit. So now let's move on to sound mixing. To mix all my sound together, I actually use a VST3 AI plugin called Alex Audio Butler that works at the track level. From the audio track mixer, I clicked on the arrow to expand the track level effects, and then on each track, I assigned an audio type. So for all the sound effects tracks, I applied the sound effects audio type. For the music tracks, I assigned music and voice for the dialogue tracks. So what this will do is it'll auto mix all the sounds together at the correct level. And then for the master track, you can choose to master all of the sound for online distribution or broadcast. And the reason why I like this plugin is that it doesn't use any keyframes and it auto updates as you edit. I made a whole tutorial on how to use Alex Audio Butler, but essentially it's better than the Essential Sound Panel, which only works at the clip level. That said though, I did use the Essential Sound Panel to repair and add reverb to my voiceover. If I click on one of the voiceover clips here in my timeline and open it up in the Essential Sound Panel, you can see I reduced some background noise. I added in some de-esser to remove any harsh S sounds and a reverb to give my voice more atmosphere. So the key takeaway and my key challenge for you guys who are watching here is in your next video, spend a little bit more time on your sound design. It will make a huge difference. You may not be a sound mixer, you may not be experienced. I certainly didn't go to school for sound design, but with practice and that intentionality and every time you go to edit and you do one more step, one more effect, you start to build up your confidence and your sound will start to sound great. So that's my challenge to you guys. Spend a little bit more time on sound, and I would love to see what you guys create. So thanks again to AudioHero for sponsoring. Don't forget to check them out. Check out their sound effects, their music beds, all of that, and share your films with me. I'd love to see them. You can just DM me directly on Instagram, and I'll put my Instagram handle here. So that's it, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.